What's up guys, Ben here from AuthenTech and I'm in a sticky situation. I'm sort of stuck on the iPhone XS. I need your help, get me out. So here's the situation. A few months back, I bought the iPhone when it was first released, $1,250. I bought it with the purpose mostly to make camera comparison videos and such on my channel here. All the links will be down below. I also did a fun experiment, swap my SIM in here using it as my daily for a few weeks. I made a video on the experience and that one's doing pretty well. It obviously rang the bell with a lot of people out there. We all lean one way or the other, Android versus iPhone, the never-ending war. And honestly, it's all good, I like it. We love our phones for different reasons, and I'm honored enough to experience both sides. In that video, I mentioned all the pros and the cons of the iPhone, and at the end of the day, even though it's a good phone, I couldn't wait to switch back to Android. Well, here's the problem, I'm stuck on the iPhone XS. I haven't been able to switch back, and it's because of one reason, that camera. It is so, so good, mostly for video. It produces these incredible cinematic results that are super consistent. I use my phone's camera every single day, capturing family memories, weekend adventures, posting on my Instagram, make sure you follow me at Schmanke for all my behind the scenes, and of course, I use it to film all sorts of B-roll and unboxing shots of products for YouTube videos. The workflow and efficiency of capturing a couple quick shots, airdropping it wirelessly over to my iMac where I edit in Final Cut Pro, and that's just one example of using my phone for my daily workflow. So here's the rub, I miss my Android OS. It's so much better for me, but I can't switch because there's no Android camera that I found that is as good as the iPhone's. It kills me to say this, but it's the honest truth. I've done a tons of hands-on camera comparison tests. And yes, the Pixel 3, for example, it shoots amazing photographs, but let's be honest, when comparing to video, it just doesn't stack up. I've tried the OnePlus, LG, they're just not good enough, and again, mostly speaking about video recording. Now I understand the Galaxy S10 was recently released, but I unfortunately haven't received mine yet, so A, I can't do a hands-on comparison test yet, and B, if my research is correct with other YouTube reviewers, they're still saying that the iPhone camera is better. Same with the LG V50, and then also there's that hot new upcoming Huawei P30 Pro, which looks groundbreaking and seriously incredible in so many areas, but then I read it doesn't even do 4K 60 like the iPhone, so that's kind of weird. I understand most people don't need that feature, and it's not a deal breaker in my book, but honestly, if it's possible, why didn't they just add it in there? So I think the one word that I'd give to the iPhone camera is it's just consistent. So let me tell you and show you just how good this little iPhone camera is. There's plenty of cons, areas that I wish it was better, but overall, very solid. The iPhone XS has currently two lenses, but the rumors say this year, the next model, the 11 or whatever, is going to get a third ultra wide angle. This will be awesome. On this phone, the XS's primary is a semi-wide angle at 26 millimeter, which is actually a fair bit wider than most standard lenses out there, which I find very helpful. From my everyday unboxing shots to landscape, buildings, vertical panoramas, they found a great balance of immersive wide perspective with crisp, sharp details and blurred out shallow depth of field. That second telephoto lens isn't used very often by me, but I do appreciate that portrait mode. It produces some really nice DSLR wannabe shots. It also helps when getting closer to the action. I really can't wait and hope that the iPhone 11 or whatever has that ultra wide angle, and it's way more useful than telephoto in my book. Oh, and while on that note, please give us EIS and OIS on that wide angle. I think it really helps out. So here's some of the main camera pros on the iPhone XS. When I do a video shoot, I have a wide assortment of cameras that I'm able to grab, but I often lean towards just grabbing this phone. It's because of that quick, easy workflow, it produces consistent out-of-camera shots that don't need much editing at all. It can record 4K 30, 4K 60 FPS, which I've talked about before. We're able to get a nice, pretty B-roll shot at 60 frames per second, 50% slow-mo down on a 30p timeline, and it creates these buttery smooth cinematic looking b-roll shots. It records in HEVC, which is very good for smaller file sizes and good compression. The HDR just has insane dynamic range with this camera in both photos and video clips. Here's some examples to check out. And you gotta remember that those more expensive, larger sensor cameras out there, sure, they sometimes record higher dynamic range, but usually those are raw files that you gotta post correct in editing. With this, it's straight out of camera, HDR video, it looks awesome, and you share from there. A couple other undervalued characteristics and features. It has a very nice balanced exposure. I find that the highlights and shadows are well maintained, especially with that HDR video. There's good colors for the most part. Often it's realistic and natural looking, and yes, it usually leans a little bit warm, but I'll take that trade-off versus some of the others. It has incredibly fast, accurate, and consistent autofocus. It locks onto the subject and holds it for when you want, and this is an understated feature. I've compared it to other cameras' autofocus, and here's a good little test. If you go take a few photos or video clips of your kid running around or some other fast-moving action, let's say you snap 10 pictures. Well, when you're reviewing them, are often a few of them out of focus, maybe 50%, maybe 10%. With this camera, honestly, it's more like 5% for me. It's almost always nailing the focus right where I need it. A couple of the complaints I have with that camera is that UI. I hate those sliders, as I've talked about before. Just give me photos and videos on that same page. Also, give us pro manual exposure controls, manual focus. There's still no hyperlapse mode, which I think is an easy one to implement. Low light photos and videos are pretty bad, and there's no night mode like other cameras have. Some people have mentioned to me just jailbreak it, and I see that there's some cool features there, but it voids the warranty, and sure, you can maybe reverse that for service, but I'm not about to go through that hassle. I want these features out of the box. Oh, and price is the obvious one. At $1,250, it's crazy expensive. Then I'm paying another $10 every single month for that Apple Care. I've mentioned it before that having a camera completely made out of breakable glass isn't the best idea. I would take a lighter weight, thinner, more grippy plastic phone any day of the week. The question I hand off to you guys, do you feel stuck on your iPhone or maybe Android? Let me know down in the comments. Don't miss my future tech videos I post every single week, and I'll see you next time. Let's live authentic.